Hello, everyone. This is a kite, not a regular kite. The diagonal, two diagonals separate the whole area into four pieces. This area is 3, this area is 5, this area is 8, this area is x. Can you find the x value in a few seconds? Yes, you can. If you used Kite Model. Use the Kite Model, that's the product of two area opposite each other equals the product of the two area opposite each other. That means 5 times x equals 3 times 8. Solve this, you can see that's 3 times 8, 24, divided by 5. That's x, that's the answer. Now, what is Kite Model? Sometimes we call the Butterfly Theorem. The ratio of the two area of the top two triangle, A, C over C, equals the ratio of bottom two areas of the triangles, right? B over D, B over D. Keep the same order. Left over right equals left over right. If we use this way, crossing multiple, that's A times D equals C times B. That's the formula we just used. A times D equals B times C. Why? Now look at the top two triangles with area A and C. So what is formula for the area of a triangle? It's base times height. So here, two triangles, top two triangles, base, the first base, that's we use notation R1. Second base, that's R2, okay? What's the area? Base time high. So the two triangles, look at here, the top two highs from here to here, they are sharing the same high, okay? So what does this mean? So area A over C, L over C, area of A equals what? R1 time H, R1 time H, the numerator. Bottom, let's see this what? R2 times H. H, the high, that's the same, right? Same. So the high, H cancel each other. You only have R1 left and R2 left in the numerator. Similarly, we can consider the two bottom triangles, the area B over D, left over right, B over D. What's the area of B? Base is the same as R1. What is high from here to here, right? So this area also has the same high. So the area of this part equals what? R1 times high. The bottom, that's R2 times high, that's D. Same high, cancel each other. Then we only have R1 over R2. So R1 over R2. So the right-hand side are equal, so left-hand side should be equal. So that means A over C equals B over D. Right? That's all. Thanks for watching.